Do you know the best way to change the color or colorize an object in Photoshop? Let me show you. So here's a real example. This photo is submitted by Laurie Dale, and she wanted to colorize this roof here in this gazebo to match the rest of the roofs. Now, I can see what she did. She applied some color fills and tried some different things here and just struggled to get the color to really be strong, saturated, and dark. Now, the reason for that is because we're starting with something which is almost white. Using this method is not going to work for this kind of example. Let me show you a better method right now. So we're going to select our layer on the bottom, and then we're going to grab our hue saturation. So let's grab the adjustment layer, and we're going to choose hue saturation. Now we get a hue saturation adjustment layer. Great. What we want to do is we want to dial in some color. So we're going to choose the colorize option. Now, when we do this, everything kind of goes a red, but notice what happens. I can increase the red, but see how these lighter areas and the darker areas are just not getting a lot of strong color. The solution to this is to take the lightness. If we want to take these white areas and apply a deep red to them, we just simply darken them. If we want to take the darker areas and apply a nice solid red, we just lighten them. And see how almost like magic, by using this lightness slider, we can go in and really just give it the color, the depth of color we want. Now, obviously, this is over the whole image. Let's get it just perfect on our roof. So what we're going to do is select the layer mask, and then we're going to hit Control-I or Command-I on Mac for invert, or you could open properties and choose invert. So what it's doing right now is it's hiding that color. We just want to apply it onto the roof, and then we're going to dial in it and get the exact color. So why don't we go to the object selection tool, make sure we select the layer with the image on it, and just make a little selection over the roof of that gazebo. That's great. Now I'm just going to zoom in a little bit, and I'm just using the option scroll wheel on the mouse, and then I'm just going to hit the space bar and drag it over so we can have a look at it nice and close. All right, let's go back to our hue saturation, and what we want to do is paint in white. So just hit the D key, we'll reset foreground background color, and we have white. Great, let's grab a brush. Now with the brush tool selected, a couple of things I want you to do. One of them is turn the hardness all the way up because we want a hard edge brush. And if you're using a Wacom or some kind of pressure sensitive tablet, just turn on the brush settings just for a second, because I don't want to shade this in. I just want to apply it full strength. So we're going to turn transfer off, and it's just going to give us a solid stroke. So even if we've got opacity and flow all the way up and you're using pan pressure, you're not going to get it full unless you turn that off. Okay, so make sure the black mask is selected. We've got white, we've got our brush, and then we're just going to paint. Now obviously this is not a great color. See how if I want to go here perfectly, what I'm going to do rather than try and paint a straight line is I'm going to hold down the shift key and I'm going to tap, and that will draw a straight line between the two strokes. Let me do the same for the end. So let's just go right to the bottom, hold down that shift key and click, and notice that that'll draw a straight line. Makes it nice and quick. Great. And let me just get that one a little bit more perfect. There we go. Great. Now I'm going to turn off the selection, and we're going to zoom out. Let's match the colors now. So obviously there's too much saturation there, but the nice thing is that we can easily view what we're doing. So let's go to double click on here. It's going to open up our properties. Then what we're going to do is take the saturation down. So we've got about the right amount of color. So I've got another short video on changing the color of something. I'll add a link to that right now so you can watch that next. And so did you guys find this useful? Let me know in the comments underneath, and also what other kind of subjects would you like to see me cover. Do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos, and hit that like button. Helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.